Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, this is Crazy Kitsune Gaming, and today we're going to be talking about another one of the game modes provided by the multiplayer portal. And today, we're actually going to be talking about a pretty good one. Ignore the pee splatter on the console, that's just... don't know how that got there. But today, we are going to be talking about the one, the only, Gnome Bomb. This is probably... one of my favorite game modes. It's like, just get rid of Team Vanquish. It's not even competition. Vanquish confirmed, it struggles against this. Gnome Bomb takes up most of my time when I'm playing this game. Like, if I'm in the multiplayer and I can possibly find a lobby of Gnome Bomb, I'm doing it. So in this mode, you use the mighty power of the Gnome Bomb to destroy all three of your opponent's tombstones or gardens. But first, you need to find the gnome. Honestly, finding the gnome isn't much of a challenge. Fighting over the gnome? Now that's a bit of a tricky one. And today we're going to be fighting on the Aqua Center map, which is honestly a little bit of a sad map. Because in the first Garden Warfare, the plants actually still had it under control. Now the zombies have it, and the place is a little depressing now. But we're going to be destroying some of their tombstones in it, so maybe we can go ahead and make Aqua Center just a little bit better. But yeah, Gnome Bomb, it is basically one of my favorite game modes. Like, it's not, I don't like it as much as, say, like, Garden Ops or something, which I realize I haven't made a video yet at the time of recording this. But, like, I like it a great deal. Yes, gnomes are explosive, apparently. So, we both have these 3 points that we both need to defend our points from getting the bombs placed on them. And we need to go ahead and place the bombs on theirs, if possible. So, yeah, let's get into this. Yeah, basically, it's not really that quirky when playing it against AI, except they have a much easier time defusing the gnome bomb than a player does, so that can be a bit awkward to get used to. But yeah, other than that, the AI usually goes straight for the gnome bomb at the fastest route possible in my experience. Now, with the way that it works, you don't need to outright destroy all of their points, but you do need to have more points left alive than they have by the end of the timer. So you can't actually just destroy one of their points and play defense the rest of the time. And it seems they have one on our point. That's terrible, honestly. Oh, I hope there's not a whole ton of people ready to kill me over here. Corn, keep me covered, please. Okay, there we go. Thank you, Corn, for eating up that imp's shots. Hello there, scientist. That's unfortunate to be you, it seems. Okay. I don't think there's anything I can do against that. Okay. Well, I can be saved by one of my teammates. That is an option. Oh, they have the gnome again. That's not great. Oh, that's not great. Yeah, they just moved that over so quick. Why would he place a tackle dummy there? I mean, he basically did that frame one. Like, the moment he placed the gnome, then just bam, tackle dummy. Okay. Gnome defused. Can we actually get one on one of their tombstones? That would be pretty nice. Whoa, okay, why are you looking at the floor? I mean, yeah, no wonder it took you so long to find me. Let's get this citron back up while we're here. Okay, the gnome is on the roof of the main building here. That's good. Aqua Center, it's an interesting little map, that's for sure. It definitely has quite a bit of close quarters, which is something to be watched out for if you're playing like a cactus or something. Yeah, the map isn't very kind to you in that case. Now, I mean, you can sort of snipe enemies up here on this building, but it's just so easy to get up here, though. is its only problem. Yeah, see, the AI, when you're defusing the bomb, you need to stand completely still. The AI is actually allowed to do some small movements while doing it, which is why they just defused it there. Of course they did. Well, so far we've done tons during this match. Literally nothing has changed. Just some time has gone by, and some zombies and plants have died. That's basically the extent of what's happened so far. Oh no, they have double all-stars on the scientists. Okay, thank you, Chomper, for gooping the scientists. Thank you so much. That guy's gonna die, I hope. Yep, he did. Oh, the engineer is getting healed. Now it's gonna be the all-star. Ah, of course. Yep, Lord forbid that the all-star did not have a scientist strapped to him, just joined at the hemp. Hemp? Hemp. Yes, they have hemp. No, only we have weeds. I was trying to say joined at the hemp. Defuse. Got it. Okay. Sorry if that sounded weird, but like, I really wanted that defused. Can we actually destroy one of their points? Just please. Oh, you put it over there where they have all their forces already set up. And now he's going on the Betty Blaster. Give us a break. Oh, they really got it on. I think he got it on in goat form too. That's what really hurts. Really, Super Brains? You really just got taunt right in front of us? Can we just destroy one? All we need to do is destroy one, and then we can play defense the rest of the map. We are having incredible difficulties getting anywhere for some reason. Probably because I can't aim for anything. That probably isn't really helping the situation. Okay. Just absolute ability spam. If anyone wants to defuse it, then they can go ahead and pay the ultimate price. Oh, he's trying to defuse it. Oh, you want it? There you go.
There we go. Yes!
Okay, finally. Why was that so hard? Oh, really? Stun grenade followed up by a freaking ultra ball. Is that necessary? Is it really necessary, good lord? I'm going down, aren't I? Okay. Ooh, I could actually help from all the way down here. I may actually be able to help just a wee bit if Pirate doesn't annihilate me first. Okay. Nope. I'm afraid someone's on the other side where I can't reach them. Okay, go in. Oh, Amp, really? Your timing sucks, buddy. Get out of here. Okay, we got it. I can't believe I'm reviving Rose. Honestly, I probably just would have been better use of the time to just shoot at the enemy, honestly. Okay. Ooh, yeah. So, something to keep in mind with Gnome Bomb, unlike Team Vanquish and Vanquish Confirmed, and even Suburbanation, the spawns don't move. They will always spawn on their starting side of the map. Do keep that in mind. By the way, this is a terrible idea. You should never use Gatling Feet. Just for some reason felt the need. Felt like a situation where it would get some use. Oh, Pirate. Hi, buddy. Goodbye, buddy. Oh, you're really gonna warp in my face. Oh. And then you had an engineer behind me. I was killed by mittens on kittens. I was suffocated by literal mittens on kittens. Alright, let's hyper in there. Try and assist our team. Bean bomb. That's gotta kill someone. Yeah, you had it coming, all-star. And except now I'm sandwiched. Okay, you know what? I want the gnome. And I'm gonna take it to C. Watch. Nope, never mind. Okay, no, I think I might. Anyone want to come and help with this? Get rid of the scientist. Get rid of the scientist. Perfect. Get rid of the other scientist. And the other scientist who came in. Oh, I don't think. The good shot chap. Oh, wow. Okay. That was... Wow. I'm impressed. So, that seems like a shot I would make when playing pirate. That was a good shot. Wow. I thought, like, the engineer would just be ending it. Kind of like I ended him. But no, Captain Sparkles. He was on it. Okay, hold on. Is now a good time for a bean bomb? Apparently it's a great time for a bean bomb. They had no trouble surviving that. Sorry, Captain Sparkles, it's gotta be done. You're a great shot, but like, you're on the enemy team. Now I've been killed by Private Puddles. We're reaching new heights every day. Okay, well, see, we are in a great position here. So they could actually destroy one of ours now, and we would still be okay. But I'd rather just completely wipe them out. Yes, there's a citron in front of me, and so I actually feel brave enough to use this despite how vulnerable you are. Thank you, Chomper, for eating that all-star. I feel like he was just about to ruin my day there. Hey there, engineer. You can leave your opinion out of it. Oh, I've used my Gatling. Okay. Bean bomb will have to suffice. Oh, hey there, what do you think you're doing? Uh-oh, I know what he thinks he's doing. Oh, he thinks he's got a fuse. Not happening, though. Okay. Yes. We have done it. And apparently I completed an entire quest by doing that. Alright then. We just completely wiped them off the board. 15,000 coins. Yeah, that's pretty dang good. Albeit, I completed a quest, so kind of added to it. But yeah, that was really good. I'm very happy with how that match turned out. We struggled a bit at the beginning, but we got there in the end. Interesting. I got 51 kills. Got a streak of 22 in a row. Apparently, I hit nearly half my shots. That's interesting. And I defused 4 different gnomes. Yeah, that was a bit of an experience, I gotta say. And I got 22 assists. Yeah, that's pretty dang good. Let's go ahead and do another one. Honestly, Gnome Bomb is a very good mode, and I don't quite have it all out of my system. You know what? Let's do Colizeum. This is where we had to tackle Baron Von Bats. Well, now we're gonna tackle some tombstones. Alright then. Yeah, I should really play one of these variants sometime soon, but I kind of want to make a video explaining the fundamentals of P-Shooter, or I guess not the fundamentals, but some of the more advanced things of the P-Shooter, and sort of what the character is about before I really get into variants. So who do I want to play? It's Colizeum, so Citron ain't really gonna get it done. Let's go with Corn. He's nice, reliable, decent for any situation. Alright, so the gnome always spawns dead center of the map. and always at a very good position to be absolutely destroyed by everyone who can see you. Citron, what are you doing there, buddy? Becoming the first strike victim, that's what he was doing. He was saving his intelligence for next time. Okay, All-Star. You really gonna have to go for me? That's how we're gonna play it? No. Leave it out. Leave it out. Hey there, scientist. Don't go healing people, please. Ah, this is a messy situation. Yep. I'm gonna defuse it. You can't stop me. See, imp hunting up the stairs? That just doesn't... That's not how that works there, buddy. Ooh. Okay, pirate, I think I'm gonna... We golden-eyed each other. Oh no, Couch Potato came in and saved the day. Okay. Because it's just not a proper Garden Warfare 2 match until you have an engineer pop up to clean up the mess. Out of the way, vase. Okay, the bomb is over there. Well, that actually kind of sucks for us, because that's close to one of our points on this map. Yon Colizeum? Yeah, the plants have a garden over there. Oh no, I can't defuse it. I can't defuse it, can I? No, I can't. We're just done. There's no way to really get there with the defense. Oh, that sucks. There was nothing I could have done. Because it just put it on their side of the map. Like, that's where the gnome spawned. Oh, that sucks. Wow, that really sucks. Yeah, Colizeum is... Maybe I should not have gone with this map. Okay, now it spawned it closer to us, thankfully. Good thing is they also have a tombstone over there, so maybe we could pull off a similar situation. If the team would actually be interested. Sunflower, do you feel like doing anything? Okay. Ah, but see, like, they already have an engineer over here now. That just took us a bit too long. Now, there is one over there, but this one is gonna be much easier. Oh, hey there, All-Stars. Why is it always double All-Star? You know what you can do to a double All-Star? You can husk hop it. Or just get insist for some reason. Okay. Well, either way, the All-Stars are gone. That's really all I care about. Getting shot in the back like nobody's business. Could you leave my back alone? Okay. That is... one of their tombstones down. We're still even, but at least now we're not losing. By the way, if you're inside the blast radius of the Gnome Bomb, then you will actually die with it. Oh hey, we killed a rocket bot. Yeah, annoying little buggers. You don't really see the AI use them much. But rocket bots, yeah, they're kind of just a bad day to run into because they deal a lot of really high damage and they do it very rapidly is the issue with them. Okay, of course the zombies have the gnome. Who else would have the gnome? We can't really have the gnome. That would just make things too easy. Oh wow, okay. Apparently I'm worthy of an entire bolt blaster. Oh, you should have stayed. Oh, he could kill me anyway, because splash damage. Oh, smoke grenade, go burr! Smoke grenade, go burr! Of course. Okay, at least we have the gnome for all our troubles. Where are we taking it? Did it spawn it over there? That's really weird. Okay, well, yeah, we have the gnome now. We could get it onto their primary point. Gotta be done. Wait, no, I don't have husk hop, dang it. I thought I had a husk hop. I need more husk hops. Does anyone know where I can purchase a husk hop? Get out of here with that. No. Not all, and the scientist tried to sandbag for that thing. Okay, so just so you know, those little satellite robots, those are orbital bombardment bots. Basically, anytime they're on the field, they will call in airstrikes, and these are some devastating, very long-ranged airstrikes. And you honestly want to get rid of them as soon as possible, because just one of those airstrikes can kill most characters outright in just a couple shots. So yeah, anytime you see those orbital bombardment robots placed, destroy them as quick as you can. That's why I was so angry that the scientists decided to try and sandbag for it. It's a good thing that the shuck shot counts as two separate attacks. Speaking of which, didn't do too great damage there. And a zombie has the gnome. Let's cop up. No, go shag yourself. There's no way you're stopping this from being defused. Come on, get there. Get there. There we go. There we go. Just don't blow up, little buddy. There we go. Remember, don't cut the red wire. Okay, that was very nearly a good shot there, Corn. Talking to my Corn teammate, not me. I didn't try and fire a shuck shot. I could. Okay, so current situation, we've lost 1 point, but they're down to one. Okay, I see exactly where you're going. Not gonna happen. It was never gonna happen. It was just never on the menu. We were fresh out of you making it. It's already completely out of stock. There we go. Really, a Mr. Flamey? There? Mr. Flamey is like a short-range fire damage bot. Why would you stick him there? Oh, you're gonna try and defuse it. Can it in, buddy? No. Oh, he really dodged it. No. Okay. Yes. And boom. I mean, that's what we like to see, isn't it? Okay. Wasn't the cleanest match, but we got there in the end. Did we get any boast while we were at it? Yes. Yeah, 30 kills. I honestly thought I did just a wee bit better than that. I mean, it's honestly, I was just kind of running around dealing with where the Gnome Bomb was. Oh, Gnome Bomb, what a game mode. I really, really like it. It's not really the best thing in the game, but man, I enjoy it. I love this mode to bits. But with that out of the way, I think that's gonna call it an episode. So, if you liked the video, then please consider subscribing, and maybe even liking. I would prefer subscribing, but hey, you know, you do you. If you like the video, then, you know, definitely not gonna stop you from liking it. And maybe share it to some of your other friends who are also PVZ players, so maybe it could help them out and help them, you know, kind of learn the game if they're new to it. But, in any case, that's about it for me. I will see you in the next episode. Good day.